Pohang University of Science and Technology, we call POSTEC, is founded about 30 years ago. And we are very proud of, we educate leaders, future leaders of Korea and global science and engineering, actually. Department of Computer Science at POSTEC, we have 21 faculty members and about 350 students who are focusing on haptics, robotics, and IT convergence engineering and different algorithm development. We also host National Institute of Robotics in POSTEC campus.
People define haptics in many different ways, but to me, haptics is one nice way to allow users to interact with computers and robots physically using their body and using the sense of touch. Our mission is to improve the human aspects of haptics research. So we have people from mechanical engineering to design devices. We have people from electrical engineering to system control and some other communication-like issues. We need people to make a good rendering algorithm from computer science. We need people from psychology to understand the human aspects of haptics and VR. These days, I have one umbrella theme, which I call automatic authoring of haptic content, which allows people to recode or create haptic content very easily and sometimes automatically. For instance, when you press your skin, then we want to recode its false response and recreate that response in a virtual environment. Or we can convert a sound like a music to tactile effects. We can analyze a video and, for example, analyze the motion of a main character. Then we can make a very nice motion effect.
I'm working on data-driven haptics modeling and rendering the viscoelastic objects. Haptics can be used in every item we build in the virtual reality world. The more realistic the virtual world is, the more haptics is needed. Data-driven haptic rendering is a realistic haptic rendering method that simulates real-world haptic responses using many measured data, such as acceleration, force, or temperatures. We are developing this technology to bring real-world objects to the virtual world. Data-driven haptics performs in three steps: data collection, modeling, and rendering. This can be a simple approach for anyone who wants to build the haptically immersive application.
I'm doing a research on 4D effects synthesis. 4D effects authoring is manually done by 4D effects designers. So the production of 4D contents is very labor intensive and time consuming. Our purpose is to automate this process. We investigate recent computer vision and signal processing technology. We apply them to extract audiovisual features. By extracting those features, we want to render effects representing high level information. Also, we want to expand the application domain to other entertainment, such as watching sports or games.
I'm working on the augmenting multimedia contents for the consumer electronics. The application area consists of the whole the consumer electronics, from the mobile phone to a car, like a touchscreen display or vibration, and even some robotic devices. We can add haptic interactions for them to improve the usability and enhance user experiences. Once the target device is decided, generally we have four steps in the whole procedure of our research. We decide the haptic actuator to plant into the device, and we evaluate the whole scenario by conducting a user study.
Virtual realities, including AR and VR, is quite different from other previous computing environments, such as mobile computing or GUI-based computing. It gives you a lot of information about what you have in your real life or your more situated interaction. The purpose of our study is to make haptic interaction more intuitive and useful. We are trying our best to provide right information at the right timing, which helps users to perform specific manual tasks. We designed some sensing platforms to specify when to provide haptic feedback and design some haptic hardware or haptic displays to present pleasant tactile feedback.
Haptics is started as a part of robotics for like a teleoperation. From 1990s, it became a big part of robotics and in virtual reality in HCI. Still, it's immature. We have a lot of things to do to make a good haptics technology so that other people can use it easily in their daily life. So I wish more people get interested in this area and participate in doing good research in this domain.